Tipper Gore was the wife of the 45th U.S. Vice President. Though the two were married for four decades, they eventually split, and Tipper's life has taken a surprising turn since. Keep watching to find out how. After being the second lady of the U.S. for 8 years, Tipper Gore was close to becoming the first lady as well. In the 2000 presidential election, her husband, Vice President Al Gore, was running against George W. Bush. It was a highly contested race that prompted a controversial recount in Florida. In the end, Bush won the election by a small margin, dashing the Gore's White House dreams.
Just moments ago, I spoke with George W. Bush and congratulated him on becoming the 43rd president of the United States.
Since his loss, Al Gore has gone on to become a leading face in environmental activism, an issue he's been vocal about since becoming a politician. He's advocated and educated about climate change and continues to be a part of that conversation. But what about his wife, Tipper? In 2010, the couple announced that they were separating after 40 years of marriage per ABC News. Though she doesn't grab as many headlines as her now ex-husband, Tipper was also in the public eye in years past. Tipper Gore was born Mary Elizabeth Aitchison in Washington, D.C. in 1948. Her parents divorced when she was a very young child, and she spent most of her life growing up in nearby Arlington, Virginia. Her childhood nickname was Tipper, a name that her mother affectionately called her, which originated from a nursery song per CNN. The name stuck and would eventually take the place of her given name. No one really called her Mary after that. She attended a private school where she played a variety of sports. During a high school graduation dance, she met a guy named Albert Gore Jr., and they became inseparable. The two of them decided to attend college in Massachusetts. Tipper went to Boston University, and Al went to Harvard. They got married on May 19, 1970, the same year Tipper completed her studies at Boston University. They would have four children together. While raising her children, Tipper found herself with a growing concern over the content of music in the 80s. From that point on, she would become recognized for her leadership in a movement that focused on the music industry. But before she was the wife of a vice president, Tipper Gore was the wife of a Tennessee senator. Al Gore held a Senate seat for the Southern state from 1985 to 1993. The same year Gore started office as a senator, his wife was a member of a group that she co-founded called Parents Music Resource Center, or PMRC. The group was composed of wives of men who were in Washington, D.C. politics or business, and the goal was to bring to light explicit lyrics and music to concerned parents. The end result was the parental advisory warnings that were eventually applied to songs and albums. Tipper was one of the group's most famous members. She advocated for parents to know the content of the lyrics their children were listening to, but her membership was highly criticized because of her own past with her high school band called the Wildcats, in which she played the drums. While her crusade against rock music raised calls about her hypocrisy, she took her passion a step further and wrote a book on the subject titled Raising PG Kids in an X-Rated Society, which was published in 1987. Her husband became vice president after Bill Clinton was inaugurated in 1993. As a result, she left the PMRC and became second lady, a role she held for the 8 years her husband served in the Clinton administration. As for the PMRC, the group called it quits later in the 90s. A few years after the Gores separated, Tipper moved to Santa Barbara, California, and the two began dating other people. Today, Tipper Gore is a big advocate for mental health. She recently wrote an opinion piece about mental health issues in the age of COVID-19 for USA Today, and she's published several books. Not only that, but she's returned to her rock band days. The drumsticks she put down when she became a politician's wife are back in her hands for a 2019 article in TomTom magazine. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.